Well, especially since the sun's finally come out. Great to see such a large turnout.
No, you were different.
Okay. Well, I said my name's Ian. I represent part-time students in the University Senate. I'm here to tell you today that students do and continue to stand in solidarity with workers. At the university, tuition fees keep going up. This year they went up 4% for most programs and as high as 8% for others. This is on top of constant cutbacks in the name of balancing a budget, yet the administrative president is the highest paid public employee in the city. When we graduate, students on average are burdened with $20,000 of debt. And then with continuing attacks on workers' pensions, many graduates cannot find work as so many workers are continuing to keep working when they should retire. Students and workers' struggles are one and the same. Corporations and governments will not help the working class. They will not help students. We can no longer rely on Ottawa or Queen's Park to stand up for us. We see this every day. Together, we must build our community and create alternatives to corporate greed surrounding us. May Day is an example of this. Look around you. There's members from across the community, across the city here, standing together from different walks of life, different forms of activism. We have student activists, human rights activists, and worker activists. What we have to do is we must take the power back. Take it back from the school administrators, from the bosses, from the politicians. We must take control of our own lives and be in control and make decisions that are best for us. If we stand together, we can build a city where greed is not a priority, where profits are not priorities, but where we, the people, are the priority. Thank you everyone for coming out and have a great May Day!
Our next speaker is Gina, temporary foreign worker.